click the subscribe button, hit the bell icon to never miss another update.
In the 10th year of the proclamation of the Prophet, Lady Khadija departed from the world. At that time, Bibi Fatima was only 5 years old. Her father loved her dearly and trained and nurtured her to become the most kind and pious woman in the world. Other than her father, the only companionship she had was of Fatima bint Asad, the mother of Hazrat Ali ibn Abu Talib, and her aunt Safiya bint Abdul Muttalib. And it was in this environment that Bibi Fatima's childhood was setting its course. Bibi Fatima's childhood was spent watching her father in a disgusting environment, where he was tortured for proclaiming the message of Islam. And now, the Prophet's only protectors, Hazrat Abu Talib and Lady Khadija, had passed away. She often saw her father with rubbish being dumped on his head for the crime of speaking the truth, and his body was always covered in blood from stones that people threw at him. She heard rumors of people plotting to kill her father. But even in this world of shortcomings, she was not afraid or frightened, but would help her elderly father at this young age. Bibi Fatima was 7 years old when the disbelievers suddenly besieged her house one night with the intention of killing the Prophet. The Prophet had already been informed of this ambush by Angel Jibrail. That is why he asked his cousin Imam Ali to sleep on his bed and secretly left Makkah for Medina. Imam Ali was in the Prophet's bed, and inside the house was Hazrat Ali's mother, Fatima bint Asad, along with Sayyida Fatima. She was 7 years old at that time, and of course, this was the biggest test of her life. The bloodthirsty enemies were around her house, and they were surrounded by drawn swords, which would frighten anyone, and the shock and grief of her father's departure was a lot to bear for a 7-year-old girl. But she passed this test with patience and perseverance. In the morning, when the enemy saw that the messenger of God had left and Imam Ali was in his place, they all left home and went in search of the messenger of God, but could not find him anywhere. When Bibi Fatima reached her teenage years, many of the companions of the Prophet wished for the honor of being the only son-in-law of the Messenger of Allah. And according to the Prophet, there was only one person worthy of marrying Bibi Fatima Zahra. And just as Bibi Fatima was the best example of moral teachings for women, Imam Ali was the epitome of piousness and generosity in men. However, Imam Ali was too shy to ask the Messenger of Allah for Bibi Fatima's hand in marriage. When the proposals of many companions were rejected, some of them asked Imam Ali to go to the Messenger of Allah and ask for Bibi Fatima. Finally, Imam Ali came to the Messenger of Allah and asked for her hand in marriage. The Messenger of Allah happily accepted Imam Ali's proposal. Then he asked him, "Do you have any worldly possessions that you can sell for the wedding?" "A horse, a sword, and a shield," he replied. The Prophet said, "A horse and a sword are necessary for a warrior like you, but the shield is not a necessary accessory. You should sell it." According to historians, it was sold for 480 dirhams. The Messenger of Allah used it for his daughter's wedding and bought the things that were needed in the household. Historians narrate that the dowry of Hazrat Fatima, which was paid by Hazrat Ali and on which the marriage of Hazrat Fatima Zahra was recited, was 400 coins of silver. Imam Ali and Hazrat Fatima were married and everyone celebrated the joyous occasion. Bibi Fatima started doing all the household chores with her own hands after her marriage. The food for workers in the mosque was cooked from her house and on a regular basis. She never asked her husband to arrange a helper or maid. Instead, she asked her father for a slave girl. The Prophet taught her the tasbih, which is known as tasbih Fatima. 34 times Allahu Akbar, 33 times Alhamdulillah, and 33 times Subhanallah. He told her that this was better than any servant or maid, and reciting it every day would help her in her chores. Hazrat Fatima was so happy with the teaching of this tasbih that she gave up the desire of the maid. The Prophet later gave her a slave girl who who is known as Hazrat Fizza. The worship of Hazrat Fatima was an internal example for us human beings. Worship is a communication between the creature and the creator. So most worshippers will be those who pray for others. You can give priority to yourself, but in the sight of Allah, it seems selfish. Imam Hassan states that Hazrat Fatima used to stand in prayer all night and offer prayers and pray a lot for her neighbors and the believers. But she did not ask for anything for herself. The Imam asked her about this, and she said that the care of others takes precedence over the care of your own house. Bibi Fatima is a perfect example of a human being for us to follow. She was noble, kind, generous, and always truthful. Through her words and actions, she has shown us how to live as a true Muslim, following the laws of Islam. We should always try our best to follow her example and be a true follower of her and all our imams.